Well, good evening.
I am Biff Williams, and I have the distinct pleasure to be the president of Dixie State University, and I want to welcome you to this concert tonight. We're very proud tonight. We have a sponsor, and I know they're here, but I would like to recognize Colleen and Darcy Stewart of Sun River Communities. If they could just stand and let us recognize them and thank them for sponsoring our event tonight. Tonight's a special concert. If you're like me, you come to this concert every year to get into the holiday spirit. Tonight in our symphony orchestra, we have over 50 students. And although we want to recognize them tonight, we also want to recognize their parents. And so if their parents could just wave here and let us recognize and thank you for raising such good children that could be in our choir. We also want to recognize our special guest, William Joseph, who also is bringing Madeline Page. And so this is a fan favorite, and please join me in welcoming him as well. To me, a few years ago, I learned about what this season really means. I had been in a new job in Indiana, and it was in the middle of July, and I had a professor that came to me, and she handed a card on my desk, and I said, "What's this?" And she said, "Open it up." So I opened it up, and it said, "Happy Pioneer Day." And it was the 24th of July. I'm like, "I don't get it." She says, "Well, aren't you from Utah? Isn't it Pioneer Day?" I didn't know they made Pioneer Day cards, but she found one. 6 months later, she came. And she threw another card, and it was around Christmas time, and she gave it to me. It was a Christmas card. And I said, "Dr. Frank, you're Jewish. This is a Christmas card." I said, "You don't celebrate Christmas." And she says, "I know I don't, but you do." And I've thought of that over and over during this holiday season, that it's really not about what we think. It's how we treat others and respect others. And tonight's concert is about highlighting our freedoms, highlighting our beliefs, highlighting this peaceful time of the year. And hopefully this time of year can reflect the rest of the year, that we can have great peace in our lives. Tonight, I hope as you listen to the music that you'll be touched and that you'll remember that every time is a special time of the year. And on behalf of Dixie State University, we want to welcome you. We also want to wish you the happiest of holidays and the happiest of New Year's. Now please join me in welcoming our exceptional director, Dr. Paul Abegg.
So glad you could join us for tonight's performance. We've got a great concert prepared for you. We are going to begin with a number that is Christmas in the celebration. That's Thanksgiving in gratitude for the freedoms we enjoy, and it's the 4th of July. We want to invite you to be the Dixie State Symphony Chorus. If you'd like to stand and join us for the national anthem.
Thank you.
Thank you. Good job. We'll hire you. We're going to use you a little later in the program as well. You passed the test. We're going to continue with a piece that you'll recognize. This was written by a violist from the Boston Pops. This is Leroy Anderson's Sleigh Ride. Thank you. Starting to feel like Christmas now, right? So we're so excited to have some special guests with us. We performed with this guest 7 years ago, and we're fortunate to have him come back. Will you please welcome to the stage Mr. William Joseph.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Give it up for this incredible band and orchestra. Whew. It is so good to be back here in St. George. It was quite an exciting adventure. I was in Phoenix last night and left at like 10:30, 11, and did a crazy drive for an early morning rehearsal this morning. So it's been a fun adventure. But thank you so much for having me back. It's been a little while, and I know that wasn't very Christmassy, but don't worry, we've got the trees, and we will get there. But some of you may know I'm from Phoenix, and thank you. She's like, shh, Sonny. It's my mom. I'm just kidding. Back in Phoenix, I was there when we had our first year of having a hockey team, and it was the Arizona Coyotes, and I was the guy that got to go to the games and do this. Why are you laughing? No, my Russian piano teacher, she did not find that really funny. But so I went to these games, and there was a policy that you're not supposed to play music during the fighting. Because that would encourage violence. And this one night, a fight broke out, and these two players had each other by their jerseys, holding onto each other, spinning around in circles, waiting to throw the perfect knockout punch, but nobody was throwing any punches, and so they're holding onto each other, and they're going around and around, and the crowd actually started to boo them, and I was on this headset, and they're like, William, quick, play something. And I said, what do you want me to play? And they said, just play anything. So as they're holding onto each other, spinning around in circles on the ice, this is what I played for them. And one of the players that was being held actually looked back like, what the heck? And the other one nailed him, and it was over. So I kind of felt like I had a part in that. But anyway, I feel so blessed to be here and to be surrounded by so many incredible musicians. And I love to take any opportunity that I can to feature each musician. And I've been this musician that I want to introduce you to. I've been performing with her for a lot of years, and We met probably 10 years ago, and I just have never been able to perform with anyone quite like her. She's an incredible performer, and she's tours all over the world, actually, and she's a graduate from here. She's alumni. And so give her a warm welcome. Please welcome Jessica Soli on the cello. So this is a song I wrote called Piano Fantasy, and when we first played it, it became kind of a fun little duel. So I hope you enjoy this. Again, Jessica Soli on the cello. Thank you. I should tell you what I'm playing now. I actually wrote this song a few weeks ago. I haven't even named it yet, but I just thought it'd be fun to share it with you tonight. So I hope you enjoy this one. Thank you. Thank you so much. A few years ago, I met a singer who just caused me to become a little puddle on the ground when I heard her voice. She is phenomenal, and I've never heard a voice like hers in my life, and I am so thankful to have her here this evening. You may have seen her on The Voice in the past, and we're just so lucky to have her tonight. Please help me give a warm welcome to Madeline Page.
Thank you so much, William. I am so excited to be here, you guys. Also, meeting William a couple years ago, we just like, it felt like we'd performed together before. It really did. And so every time we get to perform together, it's so much fun and it's such a privilege. And this first song that I want to do, this is one of my favorite love songs of all time. It's just classic. If you know the words, I'd love if you sing along. This is Can't Help Falling in Love.
shall I stay? Would it be a sin if I can't help falling in love with you like a river flows surely to the sea, darling, so it goes. Some things are meant to be. Oh, take my hand, take my whole life too, for I can't help falling in love with you, for I can't help falling.
Thank you so much. This next song I want to do is one of my all-time favorites. I feel like I say that with every song that I sing, but I love every song for a different reason. This is the song that started it all for me, actually. Very crazy story behind it. So when I was 16, I got to go on the TV show called The Voice, and that's kind of what launched everything for me and opened so many doors. And it was one of the most terrifying experiences of my life. It was so scary. And looking back, even though I've had so much more experience now than when I was 16, I can't imagine going through that even now. So I somehow was blessed with the strength to get through that terrifying and incredible experience. And my blind audition was actually this song, Titanium. And kind of ironic because this song has now become an anthem for me in my life through any hard thing that I go through. I am a strong believer that we can get through anything and that we are stronger than we think, and there's nothing too hard for us to overcome in our lives, and we are titanium.
Shout it out, but I can't hear a word you say. I'm talking loud, not saying much. I'm criticized, but all your bullets ricochet. You shoot me down, but I get up. I'm bulletproof, nothing to lose. Fire away, ricochet. You take your aim, fire away. Show me down, but I won't fall. I am titanium. Show me down, but I won't fall. I am titanium. Down, but it's you who'll have further to fall. Ghost down and haunted love. much. I'm bulletproof, nothing to lose. Fire away, ricochet, you take your aim. Fire away, you show me down, but I won't fall. I am so eternal, I am. Show me down, but I won't fall. I am so eternal.
Give it up for Madeline Page. Woo. Give it up for our drummer, Joel. Whew. Oh, man. Okay, I just need a second. I have to take my coat off. I tried it with my coat one time, and that didn't go over so well, so I kind of lost against it. But, yeah, I can't help myself. Joel is just an incredible drummer, and oh my gosh, isn't he amazing? I told him, I said, you can just pretty much just play like you're doing a drum solo the whole night. And no, he's incredible. We're gonna do one more song before we take a quick break. This is a Spanish song, and it was originally written for guitar, and it's so fun to play on the piano. It's just got a Spanish flair to it, and kind of had a funny experience. I want to introduce you to Trevor here on the bass. Give it up for Trevor. Also an alumni, and from Dixie State. And when I had my big break and got thrown into being to touring, which I didn't really even know you could do as a piano player outside of classical, I got in touch with I had to put a band together really quickly because I was going to open for Josh Groban in an arena tour, and it was crazy. And so I was nervous, and I met Trevor, and it's so funny because we got to rehearse for a couple of weeks, and then right before we're about to go on stage in front of 17,000 people for the first show, we were trying to find Trevor, and we're like, does anybody know where Trevor went? And he was not feeling well because it was not only the first time that he had played at a concert, but it was also the first time he'd even attended a concert, which was really hilarious. But he got very comfortable very quick. He's so fun and has such a great energy. But just wanted to give a shout out to my friend Trevor from the beginning. So good to have you here, man. This is Asturias. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. We'll be right back. Thank you.
Thank you. Are you having fun? So we have more great music to share with you for the second half. We are excited to continue our tradition of 12 years of having story time. We're going to have, this is the 12th year, the First Lady of Dixie State is read. Twas the Night Before Christmas. So to help us continue that tradition, please welcome to the stage Mrs. Kristen Williams.
Was the night before Christmas, when all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. And Mama in her kerchief and I in my cap had just settled down for a long winter's nap. When out on the lawn there rose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window, I flew like a flash. Tore open the shutters and threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of the new fallen snow gave a luster of midday to objects below, when what to my wondering eyes should appear? But a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer. With a little old driver, so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be Saint Nick. More rapid than eagles, his coursers they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer, and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donner, and Blitzen. To the top of the porch, to the top of the wall, now dash away, dash away, dash away all. As dry leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky. So up to the housetop, the coursers they flew, with a sleigh full of toys, and St. Nicholas too. Thank you. And then in a twinkling, I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney St. Nicholas came with a bound. He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back. And he looked like a peddler just opening his pack. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow. And the beard on his chin was as white as the snow. The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth. And the smoke, it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work and filled all the stockings, then turned with a jerk. And laying his finger aside of his nose and giving a nod, up the chimney he rose. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle. And away they all flew like the down on a thistle. But I heard him exclaim ere he drove out of sight, "Merry Christmas to all. And to all, a good night."
Anybody heard that story before? It's a great classic. We're going to move to the next portion where we're going to ask for your assistance. So this is a medley of Christmas carols, and we want to invite you. You don't need to stand, but we've got the words on the screen behind you, so you don't have to try and squint and see on your phone or your program. You're mostly going to be on your own, so don't rely on me too much, but I'll try and cue you. There are a few tricky transitions, but I'm confident we can do this based on your performance of the national anthem. So this is Harris's Christmas, a medley of well-known Christmas carols.
Thank you.
Good job recognizing that Deck the Halls was not the first Noel. In spite of that, you're still pretty impressive to be able to navigate through that. We're going to move to the next portion with William Joseph. Please welcome Mr. William Joseph back to the stage.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. That's a song I call Once Upon Love, and I co-wrote it with legendary producer David Foster. It's not about the two of us, but we wrote it together. Speaking of love, several years ago, I was like 14 years old, and I had a really funny experience. I was invited to play for a wedding, and this wasn't just a normal wedding. In fact, it was kind of strange because it was taking place in a shopping center. It was very special. And so it was like a big giveaway or it was something kind of crazy. And I was asked to play the wedding march. And so during this special moment, the couple are hand in hand going down the escalators together. No, I'm just kidding. That part didn't happen, but this is a true story. So they're hand in hand and I'm playing the wedding march. And my mind, I accidentally went into a different song during this moment. And I'm gonna just show you what I did. I loved Star Wars as a kid. It's a very memorable wedding, but anyway. That really has nothing to do with anything, but I feel like it's like therapy, so thank you. A few years ago, I was invited, I got an invite to submit some music to potentially be used for the opening ceremonies of the Olympics in Beijing. And I was like, okay, I'll get right on that, because I knew I'd be up against a lot of incredible composers. And so I poured my heart and soul into creating the most Olympic-sounding song I could possibly create. And it actually came down to the final 2 weeks before the opening ceremonies. And this song was one of three songs that was about to be selected. Now, a lot of you haven't heard this song before, but I'm going to play it for you. Ironically, this is called Heroes, and for fun, we have a very Olympic-looking video behind us just for the spirit of the Olympics. So this is called Heroes. Thank you. Again, give it up for the Dixie State Orchestra. Dr. Abegg, thank you. So, a few years ago, I had this crazy idea. I thought, man, it'd sure be cool if I could somehow figure out a way to stick a piano in the middle of a lake and have it look like it's sitting on the surface of it. And so I started sharing this with people, and they were kind of like deer in headlights, like, yeah, man, go for that. And I shared it with my dear friend, and he looked at me, and he's like, let's go do that. And so the next thing I know, we're in the garage building this underwater stage that's going to be used for the lake. And I say we loosely. He was building it, and I was, like, cheering him on. And so we did some research. We found a really shallow lake that was in Utah, Utah Lake. And the next thing I know, we are driving up to Utah ready to film this. And we started at 4 a.m. and we filmed all day until 1 a.m. the next night. And it was insane. In fact, there was actually local news that was there saying, like, pianist has lost it, he's out in the middle of a lake, and, you know, it just looked crazy. And we had jet skis and drones, and it just felt like an action movie. And about midnight, we're almost done, you know, getting ready to wrap up. And we're out there on the boat, and the piano's sitting there, and there's, like, fog rolling across the water, and there's lights on it, on the piano and everything. And we're just about to wrap up, and all of a sudden, I hear this slapping sound, or this weird sound in the water. And it started getting louder and louder, and I was like, what is that? And I look down, and lo and behold, there is a midnight swimmer swimming across the middle of Utah Lake. And he came up to the boat, and I looked at him and I said, dude, what are you doing? And he looked at me, and then he turned and looked at the piano, and then looked back at me and he said, dude, what are you doing? So we had this little moment, but I'm going to show you what we were doing that night. This is a song called Imagine Dragons. By Imagine Dragons. This is called Radioactive.
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, we're going to do something a little daring on my part, and I'm going to need a volunteer, but here's the catch. I can't know you. We cannot have met. So I need someone to just come up. You don't have to know anything about piano or music or anything. I just need somebody to pick out a few notes for me, and then I won't embarrass you, and that's all you have to do. So I just need one person that's willing to just come up briefly. Oh, I see both hands. You know what? How do I say no to that? Okay, why don't you come on up? Yeah, come on up. You have a lot of crawling over. Maybe you can just go forward. No. Whatever you want. Let's give her a hand for being brave. Keep going. It's a long walk. Whew, there's stairs. Oh, here we go. We'll climb all the way. What is your name?
Carly.
So good to meet you. So, are you a musician?
Yeah, I play the piano.
Play the piano. Okay. Well, I appreciate you. I appreciate you coming up here. If I can get you to come on over here, and okay, so you play the piano. So this could be good, and this could be bad. So if I can have you pick four notes, and all I ask is that they are within like a foot and a half. So just play one at a time, white keys or black keys. Those are so beautiful. Thank you so much. Let's give her a hand. Thank you, Carly. There's stairs over there if you want. There you go. Okay. So yeah, this can be risky. This is the risky part of the show. These are so beautiful. So I'm going to attempt to write a song around these beautiful notes. And I'm gonna call this Carly. So here we go, thank you. Thank you, Carly. Thank you again, Joel. Okay. Well, once again, I want to bring us back to the Christmas trees. I was so excited to hear the sing-along. Like, I kind of wanted to just go dive into the audience and sing with you. This orchestra is amazing, and there's such a special spirit that's brought into a place when we sing Christmas songs, and the hymns are just so amazing. And I've always wanted to create a Christmas album, and I've been a little afraid to because I feel like it's so important. But I've started heading in that direction. Who knows when exactly it'll come out? But I created a couple of Christmas songs this year, and I want to play one for you. This is one of my favorite Christmas hymns, and it's not the usual one. It's We Three Kings, and I just imagine this caravan of royalty just going on this journey, and I want to take you on this journey with me, and I hope you feel the spirit of this. And this is We Three Kings.
Thank you.
Thank you. So, that's actually the first time we've ever performed that ever, and I hope you liked it. I have to say I created that, and I also made it available for a singing group to sing to it, which was just released, I believe, yesterday. So if you look up We Three Kings and Serenade, you'll hear that track with vocalists on it. It's different, but we'll have the instrumental version coming out in a bit, but you'll have to check it out. I would love to do a few more Christmas songs, and I thank you. I would love to bring out Madeline Page, if you're okay with that. So, Madeline. So we're gonna do. In fact, I'll let you introduce this next one. But it's so great to have you back here, and
thank you for having me.
Oh my gosh.
So this first one that we're gonna do is Silent Night, which is one of my personal favorite Christmas songs, one of my go-tos. And this is an arrangement I've been doing for a few years, and here we go.
Heavenly, holy.
Thank you. This next song I'm really, really excited about. We get to bring the amazing orchestra in on this one. And my first time hearing this arrangement was today, and I was blown away. It's so beautiful. This is one of my favorite Christmas songs in the whole world. This is Mary, Did You Know? Did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you've delivered will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would give sight to a blind man? Did you know that your baby boy would calm the storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels tried? When you kiss your little baby, you've kissed the face of
Thank you.
Wow, she's amazing, isn't she? Well, we have time to do one more, and this one is just, this one's so fun. But it's been such a pleasure to be here. Thank you so much for having us and being such a warm audience. I feel so spoiled to be here and sharing the stage with so many incredible musicians. And once again, let's give it up for all the musicians up here. Dr. Abeg, thank you so much. Well, we're gonna have to kick it up a notch here. This is one of my favorite Christmas songs. Hope you enjoy this. This is Carol of the Bells. Merry Christmas. Thank you. Do you mind if we do another one? Well, if you insist. Well, thank you again. I'd love to do a Christmas medley that I created recently. And I just wanted to, I'd mentioned this earlier, but I feel like this time of the year, feels extra, it just feels like there's extra love, there's extra joy, There's so many traditions and things that are around this time of year, and I'm just so thankful for that feeling that we can feel as we celebrate the birth of Christ. And I also it came to my attention that the faculty actually just lost someone that was really special to them a couple of days ago. And so I just think at this time, you know, as we're celebrating Christmas and the message, the good news, which is joyful news, I just wanted to dedicate this to the family of Dr. Barry, Brad Barry. And I just hope that family and those of you who are friends and associates can feel some extra peace right now during this time. So I hope you enjoy this. This is called a Christmas medley. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. You're so kind. Thank you so much. I think we need to truly end this evening with one more from Madeline, don't you think? thank you so much. I'd love to just play one last song for you. And again, I appreciate you standing, and thank you. A few years ago, I was invited to play for the vice president and 25 senators and their wives at a big function, and talk about a heavy. Well, that was a big opportunity, but it felt heavy, and I didn't know. I definitely wasn't very aware of politics at the time, and I was just like, please don't ask me any questions. I just want to come and play. And I just noticed during this time that there seemed to be more and more of a division in our country. And I had a little prayer in my heart that I could maybe just write something that would just, and I know this is a long shot given the circumstance, but I just wanted to bring just a little bit more unity into that room, just for even just a small moment. And that was my prayer, and that was why I created a song. And so I ended up creating this piece, and went and got to perform it, and went home, and you know, it went well, and I thought, okay, mission accomplished, and then moving on. Well, a couple years later, I ended up recording the song as an instrumental, and I never told anyone why I wrote it. And I released it, and the name of the song didn't reference patriotism at all. And shortly after I released this instrumental song, I got a message, a random message, from a world-known, a world-famous lyricist who wrote the little song, You Raise Me Up. All of a sudden, I had an email from this guy, and he said, "Hi, this is Brendan. I hope you don't mind, but I put a lyric to your song." And I was like, "Nope, I don't mind." And what was so incredible is as I was reading the lyrics that he put to this song, it echoed the prayer in my heart a couple of years ago when I wrote that song about coming together, standing with our country, standing together, and being as one. And I told no one of that story, and I know it was just a miracle that he was inspired to write these lyrics. After that, and after my shock, it ended up being released as the lead single for the Celtic Women. They did this big tour throughout the States, and it's now kind of made its way out there to firework shows and all sorts of fun things. So it's been really exciting, and I would sing it for you, but Madeline is a little bit better than me at singing, so I'm just thankful to live in this country, to have the freedoms that we have, and it's my prayer in my heart that we can all become a little more have a little more unity and become one, and so please help me welcome back to the stage for our final piece this night, Madeline Page.
keeping till there be a new star, and I will answer you, and I will take your hand and lead you to the sun, and I will stand by you.
Thank you so much. Thank you to Lieto Choir, thank you. And the Dixie State Symphony Orchestra. Dr. Paul Abegg, thank you. Come see us outside, we'd love to say hello. Merry Christmas, happy holidays, good night.